So continuing from the previous video, in this one we will see the impact of counter-terrorism measures on human rights. As in the previous slide, we discussed about the counter-terrorism measures which are supposed to be taken by the governments, or which government generally take to curb the initiatives of the terrorists. But these counter-terrorism measures are generally having a greater impact on the human rights. So we'll see how these affect the human rights. Whenever counter-terrorism measures are used, they curb civil liberties like freedom of movement when curfews are announced. Then freedom of expression, freedom of assembly is not allowed. When 144 is implemented, then more than 5 people are not allowed to assemble at a place. And freedom of making associations. So these kind of liberties are taken away, which are fundamental rights. In situations of terrorist activities or in emergency situations, such civil liberties are taken away. Then infringement of privacy. In emergency situation, the special powers given to the army people, they can go to any premises without any warrant and they can do any kind of search, right? So in that case, the privacy of individuals are violated. Then unlawful and indefinite detention. In the preventive detention laws, we know the detention is indefinite in some situations, and sometimes some people use these special powers in a wrong manner. So in that situation, certain unlawful detentions are also done. Then denial of right to challenge the lawfulness of the detention. In that scenario, the special powers given to army, they have a full power that nobody can challenge their detention. The lawfulness of the detention cannot be challenged by a civilian, right? Then denial of right to access to legal representative. They, even using their special powers, can deny the person whom they have arrested to talk to their legal representative. Then torture and other inhuman treatments of the suspects and prisoners is done. There are various cases which have been reported where the police or the army has done inhuman treatments in the name of third degree torture, and to only to get the information, and many a times it could lead to death also in the detention. Then the negative impact on refugee or asylum seekers. These counter-terrorism measures are very negative for refugee or asylum seekers. Refugees we have discussed in previous unit. In this situation, these people have moved to some other country which is not their home country because they have a threat to their life in their home country. So in this situation, they are very, very prone to exploitation in the other country where they have they are seeking asylum, because in that country, because of terrorist activities, they might be in doubt, or the police or the army can question them, interrogate them, and can ask many questions about their coming to that country, why they want to seek asylum. So in this kind of a situation, many times illegal deportation is also done. In fact, we know, we discussed in the previous chapter of disadvantaged group refugee, that deportation is not allowed. But in this situation, many times on the name of counter-terrorism measures, the countries, the governments illegally deport these asylum seekers back to their home countries, right? They say that they people are a threat to our security because they are somehow involved in the terrorist activities. Then all such practices undermine the value of democracy. In such scenario, obviously democratic practices are not followed. Democracy is not completely implemented. So these kind of measures are obviously a harm or a violation to the democracy. Then lastly, I'll end this chapter with the statement of Kofi Annan, former UN Secretary General. He said, our responses to terrorism as well as our efforts to thwart it means stop it and prevent it, should uphold the human rights. Whatever efforts we do to stop terrorism, to prevent terrorism, should not ignore human rights that terrorists aim to destroy. Even terrorists aim to destroy human rights, and that's what government is also doing in preventing the terrorism, that they are also violating the human rights. So, respect for human rights, fundamental freedoms, and the rule of law are essential tools in the effort to combat terrorism. Whatever steps we take to combat terrorism should be carefully designed so that the human rights, the fundamental freedoms, and the rules of law are not violated. Not privileges to be sacrificed at the time of tension. These are the privileges which are given to a human being or to a citizen, which should not be sacrificed at the time of emergency or at the time when some kind of problems or issues are there in the country. So the counter-terrorism measures should be designed, should be implemented in a very, very careful manner. So that's all about this topic. So we discussed nuclear weapons and then terrorism, which are a greater source of violation of human rights. So in the next videos, then we'll discuss about the mechanism which has been given in our country or the organizations who are helping in or who are providing us the remedies or who are handling the grievances related to the human rights. So till then, have a good day.